My conditioning of dependency says, I will be happy when I buy this. I'm bored because I haven't bought the new version for the last couple of months. So if I look at all that I own in terms of objects, in terms of clothes, in terms of my bags, in terms of my shoes, is it all that is necessary? Or a lot of it is only so that I feel good? A lot of it is only to feel good, not because it was a necessity. If I buy my clothes only for necessity, I need a very small wardrobe. I actually wouldn't even need a wardrobe if I was buying only out of necessity. But if I'm buying so that I feel happy, if I'm buying so that I earn people's appreciation, any size of wardrobe is not enough. Any size of wardrobe is not enough. And that's why we keep saying, oh, I don't have enough place in my wardrobe. Why do I not have enough place? Because I'm buying for happiness, not buying for necessity. Not buying for necessity. So this outer world, my mental health, my physical health, my professional health, my relationships, social health, my environmental health is all getting created here. So the equation is not that the inner world is dependent on the outer world. The equation is that the outer world is dependent on the inner world. Fundamental equation gone wrong. Fundamental equation gone wrong. And so a lot of things outside not going my way. So from today, like a little child who is taught to create the right equations, because if they don't write the first equation right, they may take a lot of supplements in their exam. We'll still not pass. We'll still not pass because my first equation was not right. So all that we do is learn the equations, right? And once we have the equations right, let there be any problem in the examination, I'll do very well because I know my equations right. Same with life. Let's just keep the equations right. All problems of life will be resolved. But if my equation is not right, try however hard, I won't be able to resolve my issues. And if I don't resolve my issues, my emotional and mental health is getting affected. So first equation today, the inner world of thoughts, feelings, intentions, memories creates my outer world. First equation, which is very important. Second equation, who is creating this inner world? Who is the creator of my thoughts and feelings? Obviously, I. But I lived my life thinking my thoughts are getting created because of what happened outside. And so I say, they hurt me. They upset me. They insulted me. They disrespected me. They are irritating. So what am I saying again? That the thoughts are getting created here, but they're getting created because of what happened outside. Second equation gone wrong. People will do what they believe is right. People will behave through their sanskars and personality, through the quality of their inner world. Situations will not always be my way. But every thought I create is my first response to the situation. I am the creator of that thought. The situation does not create my thought. So again, going back to the two thoughts, it was a beautiful day today, or everything was wrong today, does not depend on how things went outside. It all depends on how I responded to what was happening outside. So it's not dependent on the situation. I am the creator of my thought. Take 10 seconds. Reflect on the last time you created anger. Very easy to see. Visualize that scene. What happened exactly? What was the situation? How did the other person behave? And then look at yourself. How did I react? Now, keeping the situation the same, if this same situation has to come again tomorrow, nothing will change in this situation. No change in the person's behavior. Spotlight on yourself, focus here. If this same scene comes again tomorrow, do I have an option of responding another way? And see yourself responding another way. And we all can see ourselves responding another way. And we're going to say, yeah, I could have been more peaceful. I could have been more respectful in what I said. I should have been empathetic. I could be compassionate or even simple. I could have kept quiet for a few minutes. Everything would have settled down. We all know this and we all feel this after our reactions. We have an element of regret or guilt. But why did I react that day? Because that day I believed that they are the cause of my thoughts. And I said, they were not right. So obviously I will create anger. From today onwards, the equation changes. I am the creator of my every thought, feeling, word, and behavior. I am the creator of my response. Situation is just a stimulus. Situation doesn't create a response. The other person can say what they believe is right. It may not be right for me. I may not like what they are saying, but they do not have the power to get into my mind and create hurt for me. So they cannot hurt me. They can stand there and say what they believe is right, but they cannot hurt me because hurt gets created here. But what I think in response to what they have said, besides the hurt that I create, how much hurt I create, and most important, for how long I hold on to that hurt. When do I release that hurt? Or do I feel I cannot release that hurt? I cannot forgive. I cannot forget. All that power is mine. So what is their power and what is my power? Their power to behave the way they want. That's their power. Can I change them? Not really. If I try to do it outwardly, I can only keep on requesting, don't do it like this. Don't be like this to me. Don't speak like this to me. Don't work like this with me. I can only keep on requesting. People will listen to it and often continue being the way they want to be because they believe they are right. Some of them believe that they are not right, but they say, I'm not able to change. And I can live my life blaming them to be the cause of my hurt, my pain, and a lot of emotional baggage that I have created here, which does not remain here. It creates emotional blockages in my body. It creates energy blockages in my energy body, and that manifests into a blockage in my physical body. So aches, pains, blockages, tumors, clots, these are result of blockage of energy. But why did that energy get blocked in my body? Because there was emotional energy blockage here. And I thought they were the cause of my hurt and pain. I create the hurt. I choose for how long I want to hold on to it. And I choose the day I want to release it. There's a sister who came to the center a couple of years back. She had gone through abuse as a child when she was 5 years old. She blamed her parents for it because as a child, she felt they had not protected her. As a child, how we would perceive the situation. She held on to that pain, guilt, resentment for very long. She did not get into a relationship. She did not get married. She did not have the best of relationship with her parents. And most important, she was not able to trust people because she felt people had betrayed her. What had happened was obviously very, very incorrect. We know that. But you know what happened? When she came to the center, she started meditating. She was aware of her thoughts and feelings. She stopped thinking about them and started looking at herself. And one day, she just came out of the meditation room and she said, "Do you know what? That person abused me 30 years back and actually did not abuse me, abused my body 30 years back." I said, "Yes, I know. What happened was not right at all." She said, "But you know what? I abused myself for 30 years. I said, "Why are you saying like this? Don't hold yourself responsible for what happened." She said, "No, I know what happened was very wrong. But," she said, "look at the pain that I have created for 30 years. Look at the hatred that I have held on to for 30 years. Look at the feeling of betrayal that I have created for 30 years. She said, "That was not created by that person. He had power only over the body. I had power over my mind. I could have healed myself. I could have released that hatred that I was holding on to. I could have created beautiful relationships with my parents. I could have created beautiful relationships with people around me." She said, "I lost 30 years because I did not realize that I am creating this hurt. I blamed everybody else for what had happened with me, but I did not take personal responsibility to heal myself." Now, this is power. And that one realization which she created changed her life completely. And she's not the only one. Many of us have done that. Many of us have forgiven people and released that hurt. We're really not able to actually forgive people because what someone has done, their karma walks with them. Their karma walks with them and karma creates destiny. But when I say I forgive them, it only means I am forgiving myself by releasing what I was holding on to. I cannot forgive people. I cannot, because forgiving means their karma doesn't do anything with them. That's not possible. That's not possible. Once I or someone else have created a karma, destiny is written that day itself. And that's why when something happens in our life, we say everything is predestined. Predestined by who? Predestined by us. When? The day we created the karma. So every karma is an energy that I create, and energy always returns. So every karma has a consequence. So when we say, "I cannot forgive them," please remember, we're not really forgiving anybody. We have to forgive ourselves. Because when we hold on to that hatred, when we hold on to that resentment, we are causing harm to our own mind, to our own body, and to the rest of our beautiful relationships. Because that hurt, that hatred, that resentment is a part of our aura. It's a part of our energy field. Many of us today go for energy healing. We go for aura cleansing. We ask other people to heal us. Yes, we can take help. But again, it's my aura. How many times can I go to others to tell them to clean my aura? It's my aura. I have to keep it clean the way I keep my body cleaned. The way I keep my body clean, I have to clean my body on a daily basis, right? I have to do it for myself. Similarly, I have to keep my aura clean. And for that, I need to keep this clean. So today, take a second. It doesn't take more than that. Just reflect on anything that I have been holding on to from the past. Past could be this morning, and past could be 20 years back. Many of us hold on to things that happened when we were kids, whether it was with a sibling, whether it was with parents, and of course, sometimes with a stranger. It's been a long time, and I held on to it. Release, forgive yourself, and most important, write a destiny of happiness and health for yourself, because I am the creator of my every thought and feeling. For the next few days, just create a thought every morning. I love myself. I'm a powerful soul. God loves me unconditionally. God accepts me unconditionally. Whatever happened is the past. Past is past. It's over. Full stop. I release. I release. I let go. I forgive. I forget. Just keep saying this. Even if you're not feeling it, doesn't matter. Just keep saying it, which means just keep creating that thought. Earlier, what was the thought I had created? They hurt me. They are the cause of my pain. I can never forgive them. I can never forget what happened. These were four thoughts. These are four thoughts. And now I'm creating four different thoughts. I am a powerful soul. Past is past, it's over. I release, I forgive, I forget. I forget. Four thoughts and four thoughts. They're only thoughts. They're only thoughts. It's nothing else. It's not dependent on what happened outside. It depends on what thought I created about what happened outside. So even if I created these four thoughts and I've held on to them for very long, it's like a coding that's happened here. It's like a pattern in the mind, then a pattern in the brain, a groove in my way of thinking. But any pattern can be changed. And so it requires just four different thoughts. So every morning and every night before going to sleep, say these four thoughts. Just say it initially without even feeling it. Gradually, as those thoughts start getting recorded here, you will start feeling it. And then within a few days, what you think will become your reality. And you will not feel that discomfort, that pain. It's not that I forget what happened. I don't forget the incident. We don't forget most of the things that happened in our life. But I forgive, I forget means the pain is no more there. The wound is healed. The wound is healed. You know, like wounds of the body. When we were kids, we fell down. We injured ourselves learning the bicycle for the first time. And there were wounds on the body. There were scratches. Most of them we've forgotten because the wound is not visible. But one specific wound is still visible. That scratch is still visible. That wound we never forget because we can see that scratch. So most important is just forgive. Forgetting happens on its own. Forgetting means that pain is no more there. So if the pain is no more there, I don't remember the person. I don't remember the situation. I just have to release.